You are an expert on the markets. You're an expert on the ways of Washington, and that makes you pretty much the perfect guest right now because those two worlds are colliding in a big way. And much of that lands on what the Fed is going to do, what they've been messaging, what they've been saying, what you think they'll do next. I watched a great interview you did with Jay Powell, and I didn't realize until that interview that you had hired him way back when. I just wonder what you think he's thinking as he looks at the markets, as he looks at what's happening all the way around.
Jay Powell is a very steady person. He's not somebody that jumps to the markets up and down every hour by the hour. When he was at Carlyle, he was very steady, a very good investment professional. And I think he's made it clear he's not changing on the dime. So what he said is that it's going to take something more significant than what we've seen to date before the Fed is, I think, going to change its interest rate policy or increase the discount rate. So I think he's made it pretty clear that while they're looking at inflation that's arising a little bit, probably not until the end of this year will you see any real policy change of significance. And I think that's what
the
market really wants. Well, I think the market would like to have...
That's what the market wants, but...
The market would like predictability. What business people really want more than anything else is tell us what the rules are, tell us what the way we're going to have to operate is, and we'll deal with it. And I think right now the market is, I think, always nervous. Markets are always jumpy. But I think the Fed is basically trying to be a bulwark and say, look, we're not going to move every hour on the hour based on trading one day or another. So I think he's unlikely to make major changes in the near future, in my view. I know that their comments on April were now public now. But I don't think that the Fed is likely to all of a sudden say, you know what, we got nervous and we're going to increase interest rates. I don't see that happening anytime soon based on what I know about the way the Fed operates.
So the Fed's making that decision based on what it kind of sees in the economy, also based on what it knows the markets are looking to hear. But at Carlyle, you also have so many companies and you see the inflation that's kind of running through the economy right now in terms of the inputs, in terms of wages, in terms of commodities. What do you think as the head of so many businesses and somebody who really sees these numbers, is the Fed right to be complacent?
I wouldn't say they're complacent. I think they're very careful, but I don't think they're jumping around. But let me put it in context. When I worked in the White House a long time ago under President Carter, we had double-digit inflation. And double-digit inflation is terrible to live through. We're not talking about anything close to that. We've averaged under 2% for the last 25 years. If we could get above 2% on a consistent basis, the Fed would be actually not disappointed. When we went to college, the average textbooks used to say that 3 or 4% inflation was actually pretty standard and okay. So we're really only talking about inflation that might go above the 2% we've had for some time. And I think if it went above 2% for a while, the Fed would be okay. If it got to 4, 5, 6, and 7%, that's a different story. But I don't think anybody's predicting that. So I don't really think inflation is a big concern now, certainly not anything compared to what we've had in the past.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.